in terms of his impact and his contribution as an individual, I mean, it's every day that I'm told and can see with fresh eyes just how much Doug, as an individual and as a leader of the NAG, meant to people.
Absolutely, Burton. And you know, the thing that obviously they use the My Sharona reference point, and I think it goes much more than that. It's you know, your musical legacy is far greater than just that one hit, and I think it deserves to be acknowledged. And I think it's really important that people do sort of get an idea that you guys did play other songs, and that, you know, you were talented and you weren't just a one hit wonder, which is too much of an easy pigeonhole, I think, for musical historians and musical critics.
Yeah, I again, it's I'm very loath to judge us and make comparisons, but when people would refer to us as one-hit wonders, I thought, well, I'm not sure the people who say that have heard all of our songs, you know, because I am one of our harsher critics, and I can tell you we had some damn good songs, and My Sharona wasn't the only one. And so if that's how the world perceives us, I accept that. For those who don't perceive us that way, I'm very grateful. You have to be philosophical about these things. I mean, I know how it works. People, you get a reputation. It becomes the watchword for the band. Maybe it sticks. Maybe it's justified. Maybe it's not. But, you know, you got to look at the bottom line. And the bottom line is, I have a wonderful life, and I was in a great band with a great guy. And that's so much more important than what somebody, even if that opinion unfortunately gets out in the press at the time you're doing it and poisons people against you. I mean, you just... Look.
Sure. Are you okay, mate?
Yeah.
You're good. I asked that question respectfully, but no, I wasn't, you know, I...
No, believe me, it's quite all right. It's
sure.
Quite all right. It's,
sure.
You know, it's how I feel.
Sure.
And I'm not ashamed of it.
No, absolutely not. No, it's just I think you're right about that. I think that people, I think the four of you, like, that's the statement for me and for a lot of fans, I think, is that they see you as the four, you know, and that you really did bring some excitement to the music scene, and you know, you just did some great work, and that's the beauty of the internet, and the positive thing of the internet, Burton, is that we're able to, you know, to do things like this and to get out a counter, you know, opinion of you know, stuff that's been quite shallow and really hasn't sort of, you know, it's just been off the cuff, and you know, I think that, you know, you're more deserving of recognition than what you have been given.
Well, I do appreciate that. I will quote, though, Thomas Dolby had a great line, and it sums up when I say you got to be philosophical about it and grateful for what you had and what you've been able to achieve. Is somebody once asked him, how does he feel if somebody refers to him as a one-hit wonder? And he said, well, it's probably one more than you ever had, mate.
Absolutely.
And there you go. I mean, really, it's like if a guy in his rookie year wins the NBA championship, you know, 10 years into his career, they go, well, you haven't won another one. Hey, I won a ring. You know, that's what you try to do. That's what kids dream of doing, is
sure.
Winning the championship. And we won it the first time out. So,
sure.
You know, I'm not going to cry about it.
Berton Averre from The Knack. Join us on our final instalment, where we discuss Burton's current career as a musical writer, as well as the effect of the internet and its application to music. Don't forget to subscribe to our podcast at www.newellmediagroup.com. If you'd like to comment on our program, send us an email at newellmediagroup@gmail.com. Don't miss next week's final episode. From the autumnal studios of Newell Media Group in Sydney, Australia, I'm Jody Newell, and thanks for listening. Hurts so much. How can love make you cry? When we hunger, oh.
such